There's Ella, being excited. Truck dog. Say hello, Jimmy. All right. Cross country. Ella is snoozing. Say hello, Ella. And we just had the worst sonic we've ever had. It took 45 minutes and everything was cold. But we are trying to head to Shia maybe tonight or Sydney.
What are you doing?
Good morning. Morning, Drew.
Good morning.
We are in Wyoming and we are in our second full day, and we have started to actually see mountains. We should hit our first cabin, Kelly Cabin, today, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Had a little bit of rain, but nothing crazy. We got a late start this morning because we got into the hotel late last night, and Miss Ella decided to wake us up at 5 a.m. this morning because she had to go to the bathroom. And then we got to go out again at 6 a.m., but we did get more sleep, so more to come. We're not gonna get you. You're cool though. Hello. Pretty guys. This is our side trip for just a second. Can't stay still too long because the mosquitoes are wicked, but it is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, so pretty. There's always a trade-off, I suppose. On the way back to the truck. We got wildflowers and tons of mosquitoes.
Or antler, brother.
Where?
Just went up this hillside.
Ah.
It's in this wash.
Hi, guy. You got horns. You're pretty. So we are going down this road.
We don't really know where we are. We think we know where we're going.
We do think we know where we're going. But really glad that Luna is a four-wheel drive. But it's really pretty. So regardless, really pretty. Got a little bit of rain. In some ways, it looks like we've got some Georgia clay. But lots of sagebrush. So we'll see if we can find Kelly Guard Station tonight or not, because I'd really like to make some fettuccine alfredo. There's a car.
Just got the tree line.
Mm-hmm. I think so. Everything below us. Treed. dog. Teton National Forest, and it is absolutely gorgeous. So we'll get in, get settled. Good morning. So we're off to Alice Lake to do a hike, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Bit of an overcast kind of day. Forecast has heavy wintry mix for tomorrow, which should be interesting. And we checked to make sure the heater works in the cabin this morning, and it does, thankfully, because there's not much firewood in the cabin to actually operate the wood burning stove. So we'll be utilizing heater tonight, since it's going to get to around freezing, is what they're predicting. Yes. So the forest just changed a little bit. I don't know if you can tell, but it's like a tunnel of birch. Excuse you, Ella. Traveling towards our trailhead, but I don't know if you can tell, the path to get there is spectacular, and I mean spectacular, and it's just gorgeous no matter way which way. Say hi, Drew. Ella's pretty happy. Ella, say hi. Hello. So
I love the snow over there on the peaks.
Yeah, I don't know if you can see that. So there is snow out and about. It's kind of melted off, and we have seen one other truck today. Ella's pretty happy.
I mean, that's why we do this.
So totally.
She's happy, right?
Yeah. I know.
Seems reasonable.
It does. I don't know. Drew, you're pretty happy. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty gorgeous. Can't really complain. So this is not the original planned hike. Because the original planned hike got kind of washed out. No pun intended. Because...
I mean, it was just a little river ford. I mean, the water was only moving, you know, so fast that it almost knocked me off my feet. It only came up to my knees. I'm sure it would have been fine.
Yeah. No, thanks. So we're gonna stick to the ridge. So we'll see what we find. So this is the start of our hike. I think Ella is excited. I think I might be in heaven. I don't know. It's absolutely gorgeous. I'm gonna stop recording so I can hike for a moment, but man. Good morning. It's our last day at Kelly Guard Station. We're doing our morning walk with Ella, which I think the walks with Ella might be Ella's favorite part. I think she would just keep walking all day. Say hi, Drew.
So this is Drew, and I haven't really talked to you directly yet, but Kelly's finishing up cleaning the house. I packed the truck up, and Ella and I are going for a walk to stay out of Kelly's hair while she mops the floor. Not real sure how much good mopping the floor is going to do in this cabin, because it's just basically like dirt city. But it's been a really comfortable place to stay for the past couple days. Yeah, we're kind of dirt bags anyway, so. It's kind of a Hilton for hiker trash. But we're just going on a walk, and we'll see what we find. Meadows are as pretty as they have been the past few days. But you can see the cabin right up there. Ella, come.
Puppy zooms. Puppy zooms. Good girl. don't chase trippy Good morning. So we are leaving Kelly Guard Station and we are heading towards the Meadows Cabin. It's 46 miles to Kilmer, so it'll probably take us a while because it's on Forest Service roads, but we're not really going to complain because it is absolutely gorgeous and yeah, we're on vacation. So yeah. But say good morning.
Good morning.
So it's a beautiful day.
So this is the West Fork of Ham's Fork. Makes sense?
That seems reasonable. At least there is a bridge over it today. But yeah, so Ella went for a really long walk this morning and we cleaned up the cabin and we're ready to head to our next one. This is our lunch spot. It's very windy, but so we're on this pretty lake on our way to Meadow Cabin.
So Kelly, what do you think of our lunch spot?
It's a little windy, but it's pretty. And it also kind of looks like something out of a sci-fi movie, to be honest.
A little bit.
What do you think?
I mean, this is about the weirdest campground I've ever seen. You can't see it from here. There's these like weird little shelters. Look like they're made out of like half pipes.
Thank you.
I don't know. And there's like nobody here. Looks like the zombie apocalypse has come through or something. But it's a really pretty lake.
In the middle of the desert. So, there's where we're going. Sorry, I know it's really windy. Traveling towards our cabin tonight, but we are approaching the mountains, if you can't tell. Absolutely gorgeous. And the sun's out. What do you think, Drew?
I think those are real mountains as opposed to the fake mountains that we're at the past 2 days.
So now we may have some what appears appears to be a wintry mix. So we went from bright blue sunny skies to what looks to be snow and sleet.
Something.
And we've dropped, 10 degrees or so in the last few minutes as we've continued to approach our cabin. Never a dull moment. It's a moose! Look, it's a moose! I know, it's not as exciting for you guys, but that's my very first moose in my entire life. And look at that stinking backdrop! That looks like a baby moose, so keep an eye out for mama moose.
I can attest that when I've seen a moose before, it was much bigger than that, so I think that was a juvenile.
So,
it's right there.
Where? I don't see him. Oh.
To your right.
I don't see him, but that's okay. Oh, somewhere over in there. Oh, he's so cool.
So this is a pretty incredible place. This is the Meadows Ranger Station, and taking a little bit of a morning walk with Ella. And it is one of the most beautiful places I've been. I know you all are probably getting tired of hearing that, but we have seen so much wildlife. We saw a moose, Kelly saw a fox carrying a fish, and we've seen tons of deer and bald eagle, and just you name it, it's here. So pretty incredible place. And we are getting packed up. Well, we are packed up. We're just taking Ella for a walk first. You can see her there in the background, but we're packed up and we are headed over east towards Pinedale, where we are going to enter the Wind River Range for, I don't know, probably 4 to 6 nights, something like that. We've got food for a while and see how it goes. The elevation has been more of a challenge than it has been on past trips. But I think we're starting to acclimate, so we'll see what happens when we go up over 10,000, because so far 10,000 is about as high as we've been on this trip. But I'll catch up with you all later. Let's go. So what'd you think this morning?
First time I've been out, I've been mopping and I shut down the cabin. That's quite beautiful.
Elle looks like she's ready to go.
Oh yeah, always. Did Drew tell you we saw a moose yesterday and we saw a bald eagle and I saw a fox with a fish in its mouth, which was a very interesting sight. We saw all kinds of wildlife, antelope and lots of deer, lots of big deer with lots of antlers. They still had some velvet on them, which was kind of funny to see. So lots of wildlife in this meadow, quite gorgeous. It's kind of sad to leave, actually, but more to explore. Ella, come on, girl. They're leaving out the meadows cabin this morning, and it just smells like wildflowers. Mainly because there's just wildflowers as far as you can see. It's a really cool place. So, making breakfast this morning and coffee, I'll show you what my view was. Our campsite tonight is at 10,000 change elevation, so their snow line right now is at 9,000 feet in elevation, so we anticipate we'll have snow at camp tonight. But this mountain right here is what I got to see while I make coffee and scrambled eggs and toast. So, beautiful place. That is Mount Wyoming, straight ahead. And with even the pavement.
That wasn't even pavement, that was just smoother ground.
And we're going back into where we saw avalanches and rock sleds yesterday.
And a moose.
And a moose!
Maybe we'll see mooses.
So we have to backtrack all the way back into Pine Dell to get into the winds, but we're not really complaining. It does mean we will get a late start today, but that's okay. And we are still kind of figuring out what the weather is going to be like because it did freeze again last night, and it snowed all day yesterday once we did get to the cabin. So yeah, fun weather. We are still very much in our cold weather gear, and it is just now starting to thaw, and it's 10:30. Beautiful, but very, very cold and rugged here, but gorgeous.
We are hiking up the Pole Creek trailhead towards Elkland Lake at the moment. I think that may be where we end up looking for a campsite. We are currently at about 10,100 feet,
and definitely feeling it, but feeling pretty good. Ella's definitely doing better than her humans, but there is a decent amount of snow on the trail, but not too much. Go on, Ella. Let's go. It does make navigating a little bit more challenging, especially with a four-legged friend attached. She kind of goes where she wants, when she wants, to some degree. Don't hear them anymore, but just a few minutes ago we went through a really awesome little flat spot. Must have had a lot of little ponds from snowmelt, as it sounded like deafening with frogs. But you can see we've made it up to a high point. You can see there's snow peaks all around us. That's kind of where we're headed. What you think, Kelly?
It's beautiful. Definitely feel the elevation, but it's beautiful.
All right, till next time.
Yeah.
So, trail's getting brutal. I'm puffing. Kelly's huffing. And this is Photographer's Point. And it does not appear to disappoint. I think it is aptly named. And holy shit.
Good morning. So absolutely gorgeous. We are about less than 10 minutes from this field. And last night we actually set up camp in kind of not the best place. It was fine, but it wasn't the easiest because I fell about thigh deep into snow and I was done after that. Drew and Ella are getting water from this little lake, and we're at 10,500 feet in elevation, and there's just lots and lots of snow, and there's not many people that have been this way. We did run into a nice couple last night and their dog, and they're going down to Sweeney Lake, and I think we are going to try and push for Barber Lake today.
I mean, some kind of frog. I don't know what kind, but.
It's beautiful.
It is that. So we haven't really checked in today, but this is our campsite. Kelly is braiding her hair. Ella is chilling out. But I do think that we have a pretty epic campsite. It's kind of crazy. You look way out into that valley, you can see Pinedale actually. And down over here on the other side, I'd have to walk pretty far out, but you can see Lake Barbara, and it's pretty stunning. So you can see a little bit of Lake Barbara down there. This isn't the best angle for it, but you'll have to take my word for it. We didn't hike too terribly far today. The snow pack has continued to build. We were post-holing. Sometimes knee deep, sometimes, you know, armpit deep. Which comes with some challenges, especially when you have a four-legged friend with you. So we ended up getting down to Lake Barbara, saw that the descent to Hobbs Lake looked like it was getting even worse, and decided to climb this little mountain above Lake Barbara and make a campsite and just chill out. And it has been a really good spot. Over on the other side is where we have our food, and we have a view actually on that side of the really big main Wind River Range mountains right above Titcomb Basin and that area. So that's been pretty awesome place to hang out. Do you have anything that you would like to add, Kelly?
No, I mean, I think post-holing down or to the armpits is an interesting experience. One that I'm sure we'll encounter on our way out of here when we do leave out. And definitely gets the adrenaline pumping, especially when there is down trees underneath the snow. And there's not snow all underneath those trees. So it makes it a bit sketchy, to say the least.
Yeah, it's a bit of a sketch situation. The comic relief for all of that was that I lost my shoe.
Yes.
And just the right one at least three times, but it was probably four or five.
Yeah.
And then digging that out and then knocking the snow and ice out of it and it was just the whole thing.
Right. But on the bright side, both of our shoes and socks are dry for the first time since we hiked in this bad boy. So.
True. So. You see this nice grassy spot over here? That totally had an air mat and an afternoon siesta while my shoes dried, and it was awesome.
I napped in the tent. Ella napped underneath the dead tree. It was great.
Yeah, she found the one bit of shade on this entire mountaintop.
She has taken to laying in the snow. So she likes snow. And last night she decided that my sleeping pad and Drew's sleeping pad was the best thing. So we spent the whole evening sharing our sleeping pad. She didn't want the down we brought her. She just wanted our sleeping pads. So, you know, makes sense.
Totally.
We haven't seen really any wildlife today other than what looked to be a white kind of like, I want to say an owl almost, earlier today. That was a really pretty white bird of some sort. But that's about it. No other wildlife today. It's been kind of strange. Some marmots or marmonts that Ella has scared or has been scared by. That's about it.
There have been a lot of other birds and things too. There was actually a woodpecker just in our sight a few minutes ago. And we're hearing frogs again, which is interesting and unexpected. I don't know why, but I didn't expect that in the winds. No. But yeah.
Very sore though. Every muscle in my body hurts from skating on ice, falling through the ice and the snow. And you never really know when it's going to give, so you're always tense. Just in case, and you're always trying to be ready to catch yourself. So, it's an interesting experience. Ella comes with her own entertainment. So she loves finding sticks. This has been her favorite pastime. So at least she can entertain herself. She has done really, really well.
Is that a good stick, Ella? Oh, you give me the side eye. Bless you.
Thanks.
All right, well, until next time.
Bye. So, we made it out. We ended up being in for, what, 3 nights?
Yeah, 4 days.
4 days, 3 nights. We only made it to just past Lake Barbara. We ended up hiking and camping above Lake Barbara, and it was absolutely gorgeous. It rained last night and this morning, which actually made the snowpack worse. So instead of being able to kind of gently cross some of the deep snow, you just sunk right through. And unfortunately, I'm short, and Ella is short, and so sometimes we sunk armpit deep, but, you know, and also, water added to snow, I think, makes it colder. At least it felt like it was colder, and it's rained and snowed a little bit as we were hiking out, but it's 12:10, and we hiked our just 7 miles or so out, and we got changed, and Drew is driving us down to Pinedale. We're going to get cheeseburgers.
And it is sunny and 61 degrees down here in the valley, but it was not that up there.
No. I think we were probably just above freezing when we were up at our tent this morning. It didn't get very cold last night. I think it was like 42 or so, which is the warmest night so far. But yeah, interesting, beautiful, beautiful terrain. As it's gotten warmer and we've seen the lake thaw, the mosquitoes have started to come out and they've gotten bigger and bigger. So I think we are leaving the winds at the right time. Yeah, anything to add?
No, I think that's it. I think either you, deal with ridiculous amounts of snow and ice, or you deal with ridiculous amounts of bugs. And we kind of hit it in the transition period, we will say. But no, it was beautiful. I would do it again.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Definitely, if I come back this time of year again, definitely taking some snowshoes or at least micro spikes. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Traction devices were necessary. They were not had.
They were not. So, you know, we made it out alive. Ella is passed out on the back seat. She did really, really well. But I will take a picture or maybe a video, depending of our cheeseburgers from Dave's Last Stand. And then we're going to try and find a hotel for tonight because we check into our Airbnb tomorrow before we leave Wyoming and head to Montana. More to come. So this is the Wyoming Range, and then the Green River Basin, and you can see somebody is kayaking down the Green River right now. Beautiful place to kayak. Absolutely gorgeous. And I'll go ahead and zoom out. Say hi, Drew. Elle is finding the only shade around. And then this is the range, the Wind River Range, we just came out of. We're up on this peak, which apparently used to be where the hunters and the trackers would have holiday and have a giant party every year. I could see why. It's absolutely gorgeous. So this is Meadow Lake on the south side of the Wind River Range. Here's Ella enjoying the beach. The water surprisingly isn't as cold as you would think it would be, but it's absolutely gorgeous. There's another family here, playing in the water. Okay, so we just got to our cabin, which I don't know if you can tell, is absolutely gorgeous inside. So I'm gonna pan around, say hi, Drew. Beautiful floors, everything's made from reclaimed or local, but the show-stopping part, look at the view. Don't mind us, we'll just be here for a while. Good girl.
Today we are hiking to Twin Lakes near Anaconda and Phillipsburg, Montana. It's hot, it's lots of exposure, It is very pretty. Maybe we'll get a swim in at the lake.
So, good morning. It is 9 o'clock and we're driving through Custer. Little traffic jam. Okay, so we're going through, and we only have about an foot space, but I don't know if you can tell what's at the other end of our exit. That is a go on, buddy. We can't get out of the. He's not gonna move.